वंदे गुरुपद तन्दम भक्तबिंद समन्वित श्री चैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंद सहोदित श्री नंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समयुक्त बिंदवन मनोहर वाछाकश्य कृपा सिद्धवच पतिता पावन वैष्णवभ्यो नमो नम मूक वंदे परमानंदमाधर बिन्दावि तुलसीदेवी पियावि केशव सच कृष्णभक्ति पदे देवी सत्वत्वी नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वती व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीर संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेश गौरीपत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरु भक्ति युक्त भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्वरम धैयम सदा परिभवग्नमविष्ट दोहम तीर्थास्पदम शिव विरिंचन तम शरण्य वीतात्यहम पनोतपाल भवादिभूतम वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविंद यत्पादपल्लवनखचंदमणिच्छटाय विस्फुरजित किमपि गोपवधूषुआदर्श पूर्णानुरागर सुसागर सारमूर्ति साराधिका मयि कदा कृपा श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तबिंद श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावदतो संकीर्तनैकपितरौ कमलाहिताक्षौ विशाम्बरौ द्विजवरौ युगधर्मपारौ वंदे जगत प्रिय करो करुणा भुतारो हरे कृष्ण कृष्णा कृष्णा हरे 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 राम 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 हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितोद्दीपरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासिनित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापम् गौरी निरंतर विभूषी त्वाम भागम नारायणो प्रियमनोगमदापहारम वाराणसी पुरपति भजवीशनाथम वागीशजस्य वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ते हृदय संबित त्वं निशिंगमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। जन्म ईश्वर्य सुतो शिविरे दुमान मधपमान नैव अर्हति अविदाप्न वै तम किंचनो गोचरम। जन्म ईश्वर्य सुतो शिविरे दुमान मधपमान नैव अर्हति अविदातम वै तम किंचन गोचरम।
गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति शिशिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद परमहंस जगद्गुरु टोल्ड दैट एक्सटर्नल बाय एक्सटर्नल एक्टिविटीज ऑफ एनी प्योर डिवोटी the external activities of the pure devotees or their topmost knowledge, vidya, whether they are very poor, this kind of external vichar or activities of pure devotees in order to identify them, it's very much difficult. Gaudiya Goshtipati Shishila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Paramahansa Jagadguru told that by external activities and external vichar, in order to understand pure Guru Vaishnav, it is very much difficult to understand them. Why? Because pure Guru Vaishnav, Guru Vaishnav Bhagwan, they cannot come in our grasp at all. That kind of adhikar, that they can arrest that. They will come in of we can arrest them. It is not at all possible for us. They can just hide them. This much power pure Guru Vaishnava are having inside them. Pure Guru Vaishnava and Bhagwan, this kind of this is the topmost point. That Kunti Devi actually speaking, that you are only and number one topmost Niskinchan pure devotees. You are actually understandable by them, pure Niskinchan pure devotees only. That who are actually Niskinchan, if someone actually making this kind of tark and logical interpretation, so Dhamma Vipra is Niskinchan, okay. Now he, but Prahlad Maharaj is not Niskinchan at all. How it can be possible that he is Niskinchan? So much money, power, position, property he is having, that so much kingship and everything is there with him. So how, this is all kind of rubbish siddhant which are you are having. All wrong bhavana you are having regarding Prahlad Maharaj. Sudhama Vipra, that externally nothing is there at all with Sudhama Vipra, but inside there is topmost santosh and peace inside his heart, and no external objects he is feeling any kind of attraction for them. Whatever kind of something he is getting for his maintenance, definitely he is Niskinchan. But Prahlad Maharaj is also Niskinchan. How? Niskinchan, who is actually Niskinchan? That all his property and life and soul is Krishna only. Externally, maybe he can be a very big king, but internally, like the case Bhagavan Shri Krishna all himself speaking, that I am Niskinchan, and Niskinchan, all the Niskinchan pure devotees, I am the actual protector and I am the actual dear and near one of them. You understand the point what I am speaking? That infinity Brahmand Nayak, that Sachidananda Vigraha Nandanandan Shri Krishna, he is actually the possessor of everything. But still Bhagavan speaking this point in front of us in the 10th canto, to in front of Rukmini Devi Bhagavan speaking in Dwarka, that I am Niskinchan and I am dearer and nearer one of all those Niskinchan pure devotees. That is, they actually love, they are loving me all the time and I am also loving them. this, they are all Nishkinchan. Nishkinchan means that how Krishna is Nishkinchan, that because Srimati Radharani is lotus feet, that is the actual treasure of Krishna. That Krishna, apart from that, no other treasure Krishna is taking that, apart from Radharani's lotus feet. To take that or not to take that, this is the actual thing, no, to accept or not to accept. Someone is accepting, someone is not accepting, they are declining that fact. But Prabhupada actually established 64 or more than that, 64 mutts he has established. At 64 Gaudiya mutts or more than that is being established by Prabhupada, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And so much Sri Chaitanya Math property and everything was there. It was, but still Prabhupada always used to speak that I am just like me, so much who is Nishkinchan. Only people are thinking that they are thinking me opposite, that I am so much Vaibhav and opulent, but I am Nishkinchan. Prahlad Maharaj is Nishkinchan. Why? Because Nishkinchan means that that only Bhagwan is the only treasure and property of them. And if some person externally he is Nishkinchan and internally lot of desire is there, of dissatisfaction and distress is there for some material things, some kind of sorrow bhav is there inside his heart towards material activities, but externally he is Nishkinchan. But it will hold some value? No, not at all. Why? Because Bhagwan Swayam actually speaking. That external sense organs, by just controlling them externally, if internally there is all the time you are just feeling attraction for material things, then what Bhagwan actually speaking here? Bhagwan speaking that he is number one fraudster. He is number one fraudster. He is not at all sadhu at all. He is in the vesh of sadhu externally. That this is mithyachar. He is number one cheater. He is cheater number one. It is more good that Pundarik Vidyanidhi is good. Externally so much Vaibhav is there, opulent. But internally only Krishna and Krishna is there inside his heart. It is more good that Rai Ramanand Mahasaya is more good than him, which is having externally so much Vaibhav is there. But internally topmost Shri Krishna is the actual property inside his heart. So those all external activities and all those kind of knowledge of those pure devotees, or whether they are having money or not, this is where he is a very poor sadhu. By just seeing this all externally, we cannot understand who is actually a pure devotee. It is next to impossible to understand them. We cannot understand that who is actually a pure devotee. That who are actually bhogi. Bhogi is, enjoyer is. That who is all the time thinking of material activities and enjoying material things. And who is vishayi and tyagi is. Who is thinking that this whole material activities and material world is very much full of distress and sorrow. He is actually thinking like that. And by understanding that, he is just actually declining all the material activities. Internally he wants to remove material things from his heart. So this all difference between enjoyer and the tyagi. Enjoyer is sakam. Enjoyer is actually sakam. And tyagi, who is? He is a bhakta. He is not a devotee. So all these people, they for Krishna Vilas, these all people in this category of enjoyment and tyagi, that kind of topmost pure devotion, they cannot understand the actual pure devotion of the pure devotees at all. The actual bhakti vilas of the pure devotees, they don't understand at all. And in front of them, that kind of sahaj viragya, that natural viragya, what is there, you can see, that is just next to nothing. That devotees, externally you can see their darshan, that janma, by birth, caste, creed, this is all externally, external effects, can be some problem there in pure devotees. But these kind of things won't count in case of them at all. But they can be opposite, reverse of that as well. Any kind of leela they can do, like Prahlad Maharaj, they can do the leela, or like Sudhama Vipra, the devotees can do the leela. So this is the actual categorization and distinction, differentiation of the pure devotees. We can't understand at all. These pure devotees, by our material vichar and by the top material platform, we cannot understand them at all. By that material and material platform, that pure Guru Vaishnava, in order to have their darshan, then definitely we will get cheated. Definitely we will get cheated by just seeing them externally with our material eyes, with material darshan, like Vamshidas Babaji Maharaj or Srila Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. That lot of people are actually getting cheated by them externally. Why? Because Vaishnav people, whatever kind of activities they are doing, that or any knowledgeable personality, they also can't understand pure devotees at all. These all things very, very important to understand. We need to understand that. Karmi, Jnani, Bhogi and Tyagi, for all of them, that kind of material darshan, that kind of vichar, having material darshan, that any kind of darshan they can do for pure devotees, but that is not actual fixed darshan at all in case of pure devotees. Why? Because they cannot, this is not the actual swarup darshan of Vaishnavas. By external vichar, that externally is very strict and is speaking very rudely. He is very, very, very fiery and aggressive. But this, by this, they can't actually understand the swarup darshan of the Vaishnava. Externally, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj, he is very strict sadhu and used to speak very rude and strict manner about Harikatha, and he is very strict. Srila Sant Goswami Maharaj, he is very strict. But these are the actual, this is not the actual swarup darshan of the Vaishnavas by thinking like that. That Shadeshwarya Prati Bhagwan, that Bhagwan Shri Krishna, that all his devotees, in anyhow, that kind of opulent mood, we cannot understand. There is no, but externally, by that external vichar, that Srila Bhakti Kumar Sant Goswami, we can see that he is very big Nishkinchan sadhu, that maybe 5, 10, 20 rupees someone is giving to Srila Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj, and he is giving someone, giving in the cloth, and he used to save that in order to maintain. But all this kind of darshan, this is not the actual swarup darshan of Vaishnavas. This is all external darshan. That the Bhagwan pure devotees, this kind of opulent mood, if it is actually already surrendered onto the Bhagwat Seva, if they are already surrendering it onto Bhagwat Seva, then it is okay. But if someone actually this kind of opulent mood they are having, and it is not at all surrendering that opulent mood onto the lotus feet of Bhagwan, onto Bhagwat Seva, then that kind of prapanchik or maik vichar, he can just get into this material platform very easily. Definitely I'll tell you tomorrow about, in Gaudiya Patrika, there two shlokas are there. Always these two shlokas are there in Gaudiya Patrika. You understand the point what I'm speaking? These two shlokas are already there. I'll just definitely discuss this tomorrow, these two shlokas. सो दैट अधोक्षज भगवान इन ऑर्डर टू सर्व हिम अधोक्षज वस्तु भगवान दैट इज आवर एक्चुअल लाइफ एंड सोल वॉट एवर प्रॉपर्टी एवर बॉडी स्पीच एंड माइंड एवरीथिंग वी हैव टू गिव इट सरेंडर ऑन टू लोटस फीट फॉर भगवत सेवा So that for Bhagavad devotees, pure devotees, that kind of opulent mood or by opulent darshan or without any opulent darshan, just by having that kind of ashraddha towards them, it is not at all good at all. Why? Because this is not the actual swarup darshan of the Vaishnavas. Because in this material world, all kind of material things and material vishay, all kind of material activities of this material world, whether in whatever condition it is, whether kind of opulent mood, this, that, that kind of behavior, that proper utilization, it is that for Bhagavad Seva only, that is the proper utilization, whether he is externally opulent or not. That Vaishnava is not at all bhogi and is not at all tyagi. That is the actual concept. She is actually going on to the conception of Yukta Vairagya all the time. Pure devotees. That devotees are not at all bhogi, neither they are tyagi. That they are actually going on to that separate pathway of Yukta Vairagya. With all proper adjustment, they are moving on to that pathway of Yukta Vairagya. And he is all the time independent from all the both the pathways in order to satisfy Bhagwan Shri Krishna. That in order to just satisfy the transcendental sense organs of Bhagwan Shri Krishna, he is all the time busy in that, to satisfy that. And to get the kripa of devotees, if we can get the kripa of devotees, then we can understand the actual, that we can having that shuddh vichar and our mind can become pure. Just by not getting the kripa of pure devotees, we cannot have this kind of vichar inside us. So by just leaving false ego, without leaving false ego, that we are actually moving towards Bhagavad Seva, and in order to surrender onto pure devotees, just self-surrendering onto the lotus feet all the time to do Naam Sankirtan, Harikatha Kirtan, that is the actual kind of seva. If we will perform, then everything will be done. Every kind of problem can get rectified. Everything will get rectified. So, by just rejecting false ego and to just getting self-surrender onto the lotus feet of pure devotees, all the time doing Harikirtan and Harikatha, this kind of vichar, if it is there inside our heart, then only it is possible for us that we can get out of this material bondage very easily. Kind of a yardstick of measuring that we can just understand this pure Vaishnava, this kind of yardstick we cannot apply on pure Guru Vaishnava at all. Conception, yardstick conception cannot be applied on pure Guru Vaishnava at all. This vichar will not be there at all. And Nitya Mangal, we can get that topmost Mangal in our life. That so much points I have already discussed. Why? Because that Brahmaji externally, by external vichar, Brahmaji, he is the actual creator of this material world. Brahmaji externally, by external vichar, he is the actual creator of this material world, we can see. And Brahmaji is actually all the time busy with all material activities all the time. We can see that externally, no? He is the creator of this material world, so all the time busy in material activities. But Bhagavan in Chatushloki Bhagavatam already speaking to Brahmaji Maharaj. That what Chatushloki Bhagavat, which I have already told you, that this kind of vichar, that my Siddhanta vichar regarding this here, inside, by just accepting it from your heart, and just by accepting it with the full acceptance, if you will take by your heart, without any false ego, that kind of attraction towards this material world, that won't touch you at all. दिस वोंट टच यू एट ऑल, दैट भगवान स्पीकिंग टू ब्रह्मा जी. सो दिस इन द इन चतुश्लोक भागवतम एट दैट लास्ट श्लोक देयर दैट आई वोंट टू आई कांट स्पीक द होल श्लोक बिकॉज हेयर इट इज नॉट एट ऑल नेसेसरी टू स्पीक. These all shlokas, just by speaking all these shlokas, that in the last it is actually written that Bhagwan already speaking to Brahmaji and he is giving this upadesh instruction to Brahmaji. That I am the topmost tattva, with indirectly or indirectly, that infinity Brahmand, that everywhere I am. You understand the point what I'm speaking? That your jigyasa, that the actual answer regarding your query, that extreme limit answer I have given to you, with extreme limit. Up till extreme limit I have given. That all those tattva jigyasi devotees, this is the actual extreme limit what I have already told you. This I have already told you, that Bhagwan at last he is speaking. And in the last shloka, that in the last instruction, Bhagwan speaking. Bhagwan has given promise to Brahmaji that this vichar of this chatushloki, Bhagwan speaking to Brahmaji, that if you can just accept this in your life with full surrender mood, then only what will happen in this? That topmost samadhi, that absolute bhakti you can get, or nothing apart from that. That you, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Brahma, that you, that kalp and vikalp, that even in this kalp and vikalp, this whole time factor, material time factors, that just by accepting this role of creator of this material world, you will not be getting any kind of distress and sorrow out of that. No problem will be created in that. That you, by just doing the creation work of this material world, no kind of attraction you will feel for this material world at all. That you will not get any kind of desire towards this material, because prayojan is not at all there. This is my actual kripa on you. That kind of special kripa of Bhagwan is there on Brahmaji. That's why that kind of creation of material activities Brahmaji is doing, still he is not at all feeling attraction for all those material activities and material benefits. He is all the time busy in Bhagwat Bhajan. Some technique is definitely there. This, what is that actual technique? What is that actual pathway? Like Brahmaji, when he is actually speaking, that he is actually speaking to Grihavrata, that Grihavrata accepted that, okay, that Brahmaji, my father speaking, but still Brahmaji inside his heart there is one kind of deficiency of santosh inside the heart of Brahma. Some dissatisfaction came inside Brahma. Actually he is all the time doing Hari Bhajan, and still I have to take him towards the material sansar again. Oh, it is not at all good, but still what to do? That is the actual instruction of Bhagwan. You just need to accept the order of Bhagwan by what is the actual work of creation. That is the only work of Bhagwan only. Brahmaji has just taken a role just in order to follow the instruction of Bhagwan. So, previous days what we were actually discussing of Brahm Samhita, Shri Brahm Samhita, especially that on Sunday, on previous Sunday, that kind of discussion I was doing, there I am actually resuming now. Just by remembering that what we have actually done, just in a very small conclusion I will be speaking, that I will be just speaking it again.
कथागानं नाख्यं गमनमोपि वंशि प्रियो सखि चिदानन्दं यतिः परममोपि तदा शद्मोपि स यत्र क्षीराद्धि स्रवति सुरभि भश्चोऽसु महान् निमेषार्धाक्षो वा व्रजति न हि यत्रापि समयः भजेशेतद्दीपं तमहामिह गोलकमिति यं विदन्तस्ति शन्तः खिति विरलाचारा कतिपये
Up till this point we have discussed that Atyanta Vishuddh, that absolutely, that Vishuddh pure it is. That's why that is called Shvetadvip. That just by speaking it is very much important. Why? That Shvetadvip, inside the Shvetadvip, that Gauranga Mahaprabhu's, that Navadvip Leela all the time is transcendently present there. In Golok Vrindavan, Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu's Leela is already there, and Bhagwan Sri Krishna's Leela definitely is there in Golok. In Dwarika, Mathura, and inside that, more deep you go, then Golok Leela is there. And Gauranga Leela is just like an appendix. That Krishna Bhagwan's, that what Leela is there in Golok, that Bhagwan's Golok Leela, that what is there in Golok, that kind of Leela, that is just one kind of appendix, Gaur Leela. Gaur Leela is the appendix of or exact explanation of Krishna Leela. That Prajapati Brahma, Pitamaha Brahma, in Bhagavad Gita Mahapurana is given one kind of proof is there in Brahma Stuti. That Brahma Stuti, in Brahma Stuti there is one kind of proof coming in front of us. That one small child, just by seeing that the mother and father are just not accepting that, they are just forgetting that and forgiving the activities of that small child. Just like one kind of friend can just forgive his other friend, like father is actually forgiving his child, whatever kind of activities he is doing, he is forgiving that. And you are also like that. If you can answer it perfectly, if you take it perfectly, in a perfect manner, that Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahashay, what he is speaking, it doesn't mean that from now that we will be thinking Krishna as our father. It's not like that. It's foolish conception. Definitely it is a point that infinity, Brahmand and whatever is there, actually everything is Krishna. But in Gaudiya Bhajan, that Vrinda Devi, we can't speak that she is our mother. If we are thinking opposite vichar with Vrinda Devi, then nothing will happen. that Vrindadevi, we are speaking Maya, mother. Then inside Vrindavan, that Bhagwan, that Antaranga Leela is going on all the time. That in that, definitely, that Sakhi Manjari is in the form of that, okay, that vichar is okay. But if you are some vichar is given, no, Vrindadevi is our mother. Namore namore Maya, no, not like that. I have already told, lot of queries and questions came and they become, they gone against me and doing agitation against me, that why Maharaj speaking like this? Are what I am speaking? I am speaking the absolute truth. That in Chaitanya Charitamrita it's already written. That you are not at all understanding. That Vrindadevi, you can't speak mother to Vrindadevi at all. If you are speaking, then that with Bhagwan Shri Krishna, you just need to accept. No, you can't go into Bhagwan's Leela because it is rasabhas. But you haven't understand. You are becoming angry with me. So why actually it is like this? So this all actually are foolish child. They are not at all understanding. They are just crying loudly like a mad child. Without any understanding, they are just crying. And Mahaprabhu himself, Mahaprabhuji, about Mahaprabhu Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is writing. What he is writing? It's written, Mahaprabhu is not at all listening Rasavas and Siddhant Virodh at all. Mahaprabhu is feeling very unhappiness inside his heart. Lot of distress he is feeling when he is feeling Rasavas and Siddhant Virodh. That Prabhu is actually getting angry. If someone speaking that rasa bhas, that is interconnection of rasa, like Yashoda Ma, like the case, if someone, some foolish people speaking that Yashoda Ma, that is going to take darshan of Rasa Leela, this is actually rasa bhas. Why? Because she is having Vatsalya Ras. So with that one ras, it is actually just getting cross connection with the other ras. If it is actually getting cross connection, it is not at all good. This is rasabhas. But people are not at all understanding. So Mahaprabhu, this vichar is there, and it is not my vichar, it's Mahaprabhu vichar. That to Brahma ji, lot of people are also speaking. They are actually so much illiterate that they are foolish, so much foolish and illiterate that they are speaking that Brahma ji had no adhikar in rasa tattva at all. Now you see, now you can speak, low. Now you speak that Brahma ji, if you don't have adhikar in rasa tattva, then what do you mean by that? That in our sampradaya, he is actually Adi Guru Brahma ji and is all useless. It means like this only, that how he is not having adhikar, how it is possible when Brahmaji, all Bhagwan Swayam, he is actually giving Kam Gayatri Kam Beach to Brahmaji, then inside that all kind of topmost treasure is already hidden in that. That this Kam Gayatri Kam Beach, what it is there, Brahmaji is given inside that. That kind of prem seed is there, seed of prema is there. What give? Because they are speaking that Brahmaji is busy with all Srishti Tattva, creation Tattva. But yes, he is busy. But at the same time, he is getting the full kripa of Bhagwan also. In the last of Bhagavatam, you can see. I have already given you this praman also, proof from Srimad Bhagavati, that Bhagwan himself giving full kripa to Brahmaji. That that you are the actual doing the creation work of this material world, but still you will not at all getting cheated by this material tattva at all. That inside you, this that kind of desire which you are getting of this material world, you will not get at all. It will not be there inside you at all. That kind of desire for this material world, you will not at all get. So just by getting the kripa of Bhagwan, that the actual promise of Bhagwan given to Brahma Ji Maharaj, Bhagwan has promised him that by taking this promise, that what is the, by doing the creation work of material world, then how it is possible that Brahma is foolish? So this in Brahma Samhita, that today this next shloka, it is there. Here Bhagwan actually speaking that you see that I have talked so much. I have talked so much. I have given so much instruction. Now actually I want that in this five shlokas, that like Chatushloki Bhagavad is there, no? Bhagwan actually speaking in five shlokas. In that five special formula I will be telling you about bhakti, yoga. By taking that, by just understanding that five formulas, no kind of problem can touch you at all. What is that?
Atho uvacho Mahavishnur Bhagavantam Prajapatim. Atho uvacho Mahavishnur Bhagavantam Prajapatim. Brahman Mahatattva Vigyane Prajasarke Puja Sarge Chachet Matihi. Pancha Slokim Imam Vidyam. Pancha Sloki Mimam Vidyam Batso Datyam Nibodhami. Ab Bhagwan Swayam.
Now Bhagwan Swayam actually speaking.
Bhagwan Swayam.
Bhagwan himself speaking now to Brahma Ji.
Mahavishnu Mahavishnur Bhagavanta Praja. अथो वाचो महाविष्णुर भगवन्तं प्रजापतिं ब्रह्मन् महत्तत्व विज्ञाने प्रजा सर्गे च चत्मतिः पञ्चमो पञ्च श्लोकी मीमां. ब्रह्मा जी को भगवान दे
ब्रह्मा जी एक्चुअली स्पीक ब्रह्मा जी एक्चुअली गिविंग टू
श्लोकी मीमां विद्यां वत्सो तत्याम निबोधमे.
That I am that five shloki bhagavatam I used to give at the time of doing the creation work also. You will not at all get cheated at all by doing by reading that pancha shloki bhagavat. That these five shloki, now when you will go ahead, Bhagwan actually speaking to Brahma. This I will also give you the actual purport of that.
Bhagavantam Prajapatim Brahman Mahatattva Vigyane Prajasargi Chachetmati Pancha Slokam Imam Vidyam Batsu Datyam Nibodhavi.
Bhagwan speaking.
Shargarbo Brahma ka stav shoban karke.
Just by hearing the Brahma stav, Bhagwan Govind become very much happy with him. After that, Brahma ji has given that Sargarbo stav. That Sargarbo stav, just by hearing that, Bhagwan Shri Krishna speaking to Brahma that, hey Brahman, that maybe that Mahatattva Vigyan, that by doing the infinity creation, that kind of feeling or desire is coming inside you because sanskar actually is being made by Bhagwan previously like that only. By the actual kripa of Bhagwan only this sanskar is getting. That Sarvargustav, that same Sarvargustav, by hearing that Bhagwan Shri Krishna actually speaking to Brahma Ji, that hey Brahman, that maybe that Mahatattva Vigyan, that you want to do the creation, that kind of desire actually is coming inside you. But hey, Vats means just to child we are speaking, that he is his own child. No, that hey Vats, here Bhagwan speaking that my in front of me, that five shloki Bhagavatam, you just hear that in front of me, that I'll be telling you that five shloki Bhagavatam, that kind of vidya, that kind of five shloki vidya you just hear from me.
पंचश्लोकमिमां विद्यां वत्सुदत्यां निबोधमि.
That is a Sarvagarustava. By hearing that Bhagavan Sri Krishna actually speaking to Brahma, that hey Brahman, that in Mahatattva Vigyan, that kind of sanskar you are feeling to have the desire to create this material world, that you in front of me, that in front of me, this kind of five shloki Bhagavatam, you just hear that, after which I want to give it to you. Just hear that from me. That is five shloki vidya, what I want to give now, one after another, slowly, steadily. I will be started speaking. Maybe that is the actual last with that five shloka. That Bhagwan, that special Updesh given to Brahma, that kind of topmost Vidya, what he wants to give, with that only, that Sri Sri Brahma Samhita, that will be just, will be finishing that by today. It will, we can just make sure that it is finished today. Maybe today or tomorrow we will make in this vichar. So what is the actual purport of this? What actually Bhagwan wants to speak to Brahma? The actual purport is that the shloka which I have already told, what is the actual purport of that? The actual purport is that Brahma is actually becoming very restless and is with full desirable about the Roop Gun Leela of Bhagwan. He is doing Kirtan, he is doing that. By just speaking the Krishna Murare like this, he is getting, Bhagwan is becoming very happy with him. You just be careful on this point, what I am speaking.
Atho vacha Mahavishnura Bhagavantam Prajapatim Brahman Mahatattva Vijnana Pajasarge Chachatmati Pancha Slokam Imam Vidyam Vatsu Datyam Nibodhame.
So on Brahma Ji Bhagwan is very much satisfied when Brahma speaking that Krishna Govinda Hare Murare, when he is just having desirable Brahma Ji to hear the Roop Gun Leela of Bhagwan. Bhagwan become very happy just by hearing his names, and inside the heart of Brahma Ji, that kind of desire for this material world definitely will be there. Why? Because if this creation desire will not be there, then who will be actually responsible to do the creation work then? If inside the heart of someone that no kind of desire is there for creation, then whether he will do the creation, that how he will do the work of creation then? You tell me, if no desire is there, that this material world, no kind of desire is there, then why he will marry? If he will not, he will do like Bilwa Mangal Thakur, he will do like that. Definitely he will do like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has already shown us this Leela, that this material world, in order to do that, definitely it is useful. Why? Because we can do the seva of Bhagwan here. That I haven't done any, I have shown lot of vairagya, I have not done marriage. Are, what is the actual satisfaction Bhagwan is getting out of your vairagya? If someone speaking in front of Prabhupada, some person speaking, that he is actually speaking in front of Prabhupada, that we, I am also brahmachari. I haven't done any kind of marriage or own activities. So now this is actually speaking with fully false ego. Then Prabhupada, just by hearing, is just smiling and he is speaking that by not marriage, doing marriage, that is the actual criteria to show that you are actually having vairagya. Then this is the actual symptom of brahmachari. Then all those beasts and birds which are there in the zoo, that all those pandas and tigers, they are also brahmachari also. Just not to do marriage, if that is the actual symptom of vairagya, then okay, then the beast and birds in the zoo, they are also brahmachari. They are actually more vairagi than you. Why? It means that it is not the criteria. That vairagya is there externally, externally vishay is there. Externally you have vishay. If you are having that external, by external vichar, if you are having material opulence also, but still inside your heart no vishay is there, then only and only that Bhagavad Seva vichar is there, then that is the actual vairagya that I have already told you. That in Vani, in the boat, boat is there in water, and in water that boat will be there, no? That there is actually no problem in that, but when in boat water will come, then what will happen? Then the boat will just drown into water, no? Understand the point. So that is the actual point which you need to understand. So Brahmaji actually becoming very much desirable to by just speaking the Roop Gundila of Bhagwan and speaking Hey Krishna, Hey Govinda, Hey Murare. Just by speaking this, Bhagwan become very much satisfied with Brahma. And Brahmaji inside his heart, that kind of creation desire definitely is there. That's why this creation work is going on. That Prishni Garbha means that I want to speak that Dharadrun. Who is Dharadrun? He is actually Nandan Yashomati Maya. Both are Dharadrun. You understand the point? That about them, Dharadrun, in the Purans it is written that Bhagwan himself also speaking the same point here, that when Devaki Maya is actually in the Kansa jail, in the Kansa's prison, at the time of staying there, Bhagwan actually doing stuti, and Bhagwan speaking that in order to just remember both of you, that you have, that in the previous kalp a lot of bhajan you have done of me, that with full Srishti mood you have done lot of example I have given, like Kardam Rishi. About this also, about Kardam Rishi, Bhagwan Shri Krishna having so much love, but still Kardam Rishi, that kind of desire for this kingship and all, he has that desire and has started worshipping Bhagwan with that desire. And after that, that Daksha Prajapati who is there, he is also done austerity and penances by having that desire towards material objects, material opulences. Lot of examples are there regarding this. That if there no desire is of this material world is not there inside your heart, then how it is possible that you will be doing creation? That no desire is there for the creation, then how it is possible? So inside the heart of Brahma, that is there, of the creation work is there inside the heart of Brahma, definitely in hidden form. Vishuddha Ananya Bhakti, that is the just by accepting the Bhagavat Agya, what is actually there with full transcendental kama, that all those materially jivas, it can be getting accepted in our life. You just be cautious what I am speaking, very careful on this point, that inside Brahma that creation, that kama for creation, that it is there in hidden form. Lot of Bhakti, you know, Thakur has done, and lot of pramana are there in the shastras as well. Dharadron, Nandi Yashoda, they are. So those, all those material jivas, by those all material jivas, that Vishuddha Ananya Bhakti, that Vishuddha Ananya Bhakti only, by doing that Vishuddha Ananya Bhakti, that by not accepting Bhagavad Agya, that kind of creation of that Kaam, Bhagavan is already giving that role to Brahma. But that by taking the support of Kaam, all those material sansari jivas, that all those material jivas, by them there is one kind of, it can just get created more and more. That kind of work Krishna actually speaking to Brahma. He is actually speaking this point to Brahma, that Chid Gyani and Mahatattva Gyani, that Chid Gyan, what is there, that is, that Chid Gyani is Mahatattva Gyan. Mahatattva Gyan, that Mahatattva, about that knowledge you are getting about Mahatattva. That Chid Gyani, that Chid Gyan, knowledge of Chid, that about Bhagwan, whatever is there, that Chid Gyani, that is the Mahatattva Gyan. Mahatattva Gyan, that is the topmost Gyan. That if Bhagwan speaking to Brahmaji, that maybe if you are, if you are, beta, if you are, that Brahma is actually very old and Bhagavan is actually very young. It's not external bhav. It doesn't depend on that, no. This is just material conception here. So lot of loads and loads of years old, but still it he's look like 4 to 5 years old. That from infinity time period there Bhagavan is there. So Vishuddha Ananya Bhakti, by taking the same Bhagavat Agya, that kind of Kama, by taking the support of that Kama, that all those material sansari jiva, it can get established. That everything, child, everything is being reproduced by, in this no kind of sanshe is there at all. That's why Brahmaji speaking to Bhagwan, that Krishna speaking to Brahma, and just started speaking one after other, that Chid Gyani and Mahatta Gyan. If you are by taking the support of same Gyan, and you are doing the desire of this creation by taking the support of this Gyan, Chid Gyan, that I'll be giving you five shloki Bhagavatam. I'll be speaking you in front of you. By that five shlokas about Bhakti Vidya, I will be speaking. That topmost rahasya, hidden secret, you definitely have to accept that. Why? Because by accepting that Bhagavad Agya, that kind of creation work, so that Bhakti Sadhan is very much important to do. About this Bhagavan actually speaking, what actually is speaking here? Just by that kind of Bhagavad Agya, when you are accepting that, when you are actually accepting that Bhakti Sadhan and you are doing the creation work, in the same way Bhagavan actually speaking. After that, that five shloki, what Bhagwan is speaking, that five shlokas, in that Bhagwan is speaking to Brahmaji Maharaj. What Bhagwan speaking here? Prabuddhi gyan bhakti bhyam atmani anando chinmai.
Is
Here actually very deep vichar is there in this. Here, what does it mean actually? The actual meaning of this is that by Gyan and Bhakti, surely, definitely, that kind of Gyan, it is strictly prohibited, which is actually, Brahmaji has just thrown it away. So this is not the actual Gyan. Here the actual which is actually anukul to bhakti, that kind of Gyan and knowledge, it is signified here. So by Gyan and bhakti only, when inside you that kind of topmost chit anubhuti, that transcendental realization you are getting inside your heart, it is actually getting manifested inside your heart. After getting manifestation, that Atma Priya, that with me, you will get Bhagavat Prem Lakshana, you will get topmost attachment, you will get attracted to me. So that in five shloki, this first shloka is this, that Bhagwan, the actual instruction of Bhagwan is this, that Gyan and by Gyan and Bhakti only, when we will go ahead, we can get the transcendental realization. It is getting, we are getting that transcendental realization. After that only, that Atma Priya Shri Krishna, that Bhagavat Prem Lakshan, symptoms of Bhagavat Prem and Uttama Bhakti is getting manifested automatically. What actually written here? This actually written here. Inside this, what is the actual vichar inside this? What is the in-depth vichar in this? We just gonna manifest that. The actual thing is that here what Gyan I have already started in the beginning, that kind of Gyan I have already told you, no? That 2 minutes before I have told that this kind of Gyan where it is mentioned here, it is surely not. This is not Akhoj Gyan, about which Brahmaji Maharaj speaking in 10th canto. That you just need to throw the actual knowledge which you are actually depositing. But why actually Gyan speaking here? Here actually what Maharaj Gyan is actually indicated, that about natural Gyan, relationship with Bhagwan, Sambandha Gyan, it is actually getting manifested. This is actually being spoken here, that you are mine and I am yours. This kind of relationship actually with Bhagwan, that is actually indicated here. So this kind of Gyan, this is not at all dry Gyan. Not like Mayavadi Gyan which Brahmaji Maharaj is speaking. This is not at all Mayavadi Gyan at all. Gyan is definitely very important. When? In Rasamrit Sindhu also, Rupa Goswami Pad has written there in Rasamrit Sindhu. Here actually already written by Rupa Goswami Pad in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. So Anyabala Shita Sunya means that kind of Gyan and Karma. Why actually not speaking Gyan Karnadi Shunyam? It means that kind of Gyan and Karma which is Anukulya, which is Anukulya for Bhakti Karma and Bhakti Gyan. That kind of, it also looks like the same as the Karma Kant, but it's not like that at all. It's totally reverse and opposite. And other kind of that what is actually kind of bhakti sambandhigan is very much important with that. You can't throw that away. So that's why anavrita, that word is written. That kind of material realization and material gyan, you just need to throw it away. and material karma, that is strictly prohibited. And that's why it is written before. Anya Bilash means, why not, it's not written Anya Bilash Shunyam. It's written Anya Bilash Shita Shunyam, not written Anya Bilash Shunyam. By speaking Anya Bilash Shita means that if there is any root, it's some hidden root is there, then you just need to throw it away completely. That's why it is written here, Anya Bilash Shita. That's why this word is written. But Gyan Karandi Anabrita means what, that kind of material Gyan and material karma, you just need to throw it away. That kind of material karma, that which has no connection with bhakti, you just need to cut and throw it away. All. So here, this Bhagavad Sakshatrup Ved Puran Upanishad, that all these Bhakti Shastras, in that which I can get some relationship with Bhagwan, I can feel and realize the actual relationship with Bhagwan, that kind of vichar, that are all Bhakti Shastra. And Sadachar, that pure devotees, that kind of Shuddhachar, that is actually called Sadachar. That the actual acharan of the sadhu, pure guru, Vaishnav, that is actually called acharan. That is the topmost sadachar, that is actually called acharan of the pure devotees, that is called sadachar. You understand the point what I'm speaking? So here, that from the shastras, that sadachar, that for pure devotees, that kind of sadachar, that rag bhakta, that rag mark sadhu, in order to become that kind of acharan you need to follow from the pure devotees. That from the shastras, that just by getting the 10 dashamul from the shastras, important dashamul tattva from the shastras, Ram gun, Ram, name, form, and Leela, after getting Harinam, that kind of continuous non-stop Anushilan, by that, if you are getting that, it will just get converted into practice. All the time you just need to practice it by sadhana. In this, what will happen? That Shastra Vachan, that Shastras are our eyes. Shastras are like eyes, which helps us to give us that bhakti pathway. And sadhu sangha, these are my life and vitals of my life. Association of sadhu. That with full sadachar, I have to get the anushilan of harinam slowly, steadily. And that kind of 10 nayam nam aparad, we just need to remove that completely. It will not at all stay inside your heart at all. That 10 kind of nam aparad will totally get destroyed. That all those sadhus, that kind of sadhus, they are actually free from all kind of aparad. Just this kind of naam, sankirtan, you just need to do under their guidance all the time. That the sadhus, what they are actually doing, this topmost naam sankirtan, that Bhagwan, that having the relationship with Bhagwan, topmost relationship, that kind of donation of naam sankirtan which they are giving to us, that all those pure guru Vaishnav, they are actually without any aparad, and they are having that eyes of the Naam Sankirtan. They are actually donating it to others as well. So this type of topmost sadhan and practice, slowly, steadily, under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnav, that sadhya phal, that prem bhakti is getting manifested automatically. Mahaprabhu actually speaking in Rai Ramanand Sambad to Rai Mahashaya, that shastras is our eyes, and if the actual shastra praman, we are actually just kicking it away, and the other acharan etiquette, we are not at all giving any respect to that, then what will stay? nothing will stay at all. What is there at all there, nothing will stay at all. If you will just disrespect your Guru Vaishnava and Shastra, he is not at all accepting Shastra Praman. He is not at all caring for that at all. He is actually not at all caring about any kind of vichar of the Shastra. Nothing it is. And according to their own vichar, they are just building up their bhakti. So this is actually one kind of singing. One nice song is there in Hindi. Apni dhun mein rehta hun all the time. He is in his own thinking. Whatsoever you will speak, that our Nishkinchan Maharaj from Punjab, from Chandigarh, he always used to speak this. That whatever kind of flute you will, if you will just do Shastra Pravachan in front of all those foolish people, the ox will do, like that. So it's like that. Just like that, they will be doing that. If you will be just speaking or just doing some flute work in front of them, they are all the time in their own thinking. They don't want to listen to anyone. Always he wants to be in his own thinking all the time. So all those pure Guru Vaishnav, that kind of no aparath, that aparath shunya, without any aparath, they are actually taking Naam Sankirtan. We just need to practice that under their guidance. That kind of sadhana, by doing that, we can get that topmost prem lakshana bhakti. We can get, because without any kind of sadhana that we are getting sadhya vastu, it is not at all possible at all.
सदाचारिस्तदभ्यासैर्निरन्तरं बोधयत्वात्मनात्मनं भक्तिं उत्तमां लभेत. क्या बोला?
What actually written here?
प्रमाणैस्तत् सदाचारि स्तदभ्यासैर्निरन्तरं बोधयत्वात्मनात्मनं भक्तिम ओपि उत्तमाम लभेत. प्रमाणै स्तत् सदाचारै तद् अभ्यासैर् निरन्तरं बोधयत्वात्मनात्मनं भक्तिम ओपि उत्तमाम लभेत. आई बात समझ?
यू अंडरस्टैंड द पॉइंट व्हाट आई एम स्पीकिंग?
प्रमाणै स्तत् सदाचारै तद् अभ्यासैर् निरन्तरं बोधयत्वात्मनात्मनं भक्तिम कोपि उत्तमं लभे. इसका
दिस इज द एक्चुअल एक्सप्लेनेशन आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन टू यू. दैट दोज हु आर नॉट एट ऑल एक्सेप्टिंग शास्त्र, व्हाट इज द एक्चुअल विचार फॉर देम? What is the actual vichar is coming there? He is actually foolish, number one. He won't understand what actually written in the Shastras. So I have just given you an overview about this shloka, about 59 number shloka. And when you will go ahead, if you will make this vichar, then you can understand this point, that all those pure Guru Vaishnav and sadhus, pure sadhus, that kind of acharan what they are doing, that is actually called sadachar. That is actually called sadachar. What do you mean by sadachar? That all those pure Guru Vaishnav, that kind of acharan, that is actually called sadachar. Actually, that is called actual sadachar. And without sadachar, no kind of activities or sadhana you can practice at all. It will not at all get siddhi in your life without sadachar. That without sadachar, no kind of activity can get siddhi in life at all. That sadachar is very much important. Without sadachar, it is not at all possible to get siddhi in that particular sadhan. And that sad means sadhu, and sat means that all those sat means that pure Guru Vaishnav, that kind of acharan, that is called sadachar. That is actually called sadachar. Sadachar means that this word, that what I've already given you the explanation, it's like that. And if you will not be following Sadachar, then anyhow, no kind of advantage you will get at all. That no kind of advantage you can get by following Sadachar, no kind of advantage at all. So this Bhagavad Shastra Swarup, that Ved, Puran, Gita, all actually are the eyes, are the Shastra Chakshu. These are the eyes of Shastras, that our internal eyes are actually opened. It is just giving us an opening, that actual Tattva Drishti, that eyes, Bhagavad Mahaji, Bhagavadji Mahapuran, all Vedan Sutra, Chaitanya Charitamrita, Chaitanya Bhagavat, these are just our eyes, which internal eyes, that Tattva eyes which we are getting, that externally what our eyes we are seeing, material eyes, by which we are doing, that we are just man, woman, stool and urine, blood and flesh, we are just taking darshan by this kind of eyes. About this I have already told you, that Bhagavan actually speaking, that as you are getting more and more excited about my Harikatha and Kirtan, so that day by day, fraction of second, you will be increasing that kind of Tattva eyes, Tattva Darshu, Tattva Chakshu, that Tattva eyes, Tattva Darshan you will get in order to just take my Darshan. That is the actual point which we just need to understand. What is the actual proof? That is actually Shastra. If someone actually speaking, I won't accept Shastra, he is actually foolish, number one. What to do for them? In Gita, Bhagavan Shri Krishna is actually speaking to Arjun, that okay, you just speak one thing to me, that what to do and what not to do, and what is good and what is not good, that this all, how I can make vichar, that according to the Shastra vichar only, you just need to make the decision. That Bhagavan has given this answer, what to do, what not to do, what is good, what not is not too good. Even the whole world can go into hell, but still we have to see the Shastra vichar. That Bhagavan with full prema, that he is actually accepting the Shastra. Maybe he can just break the Shastric vichar, that is exclusive for just by prema. Bhagavan can just break the rules of the Shastras and can go onto the premic pathway full of prema for just for devotees, that is exclusive. But to Arjun, Bhagavan speaking, that Shastra Vidhi, this already written, that in the Shastras, that according to that only we just need to follow ourselves. Shastra is very much important, Shastra Vidhi, rules and regulations of the Shastras. That kind of Kartavya Karma, what kind of karma you just need to do, that is the actual pathway to do. If some confusion is coming, that on the basis of Shastra Praman proof, if some kind of confusion is coming there, okay, so Ved, Puran, Gita, all actually are Bhakti Shastra, and these are our actual Atma eyes, eyes of Atma, and Adarsh Acharan and Sadachar of pure Bhakti, what given by pure Guru Vaishnav to us, that kind of Rag Marg, it can be of the pathway of Rag Marg, if I can go up till that point. Otherwise, in Shuddha Bhakti can also be on the pathway of Vidhi Marg, if his Acharan is topmost Sadachar, that is actually called Sadachar, that is the topmost point which you need to follow. That is Shastra's Dashamul, that about Dashamul, that Dashamul Tattva, about that our Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written very nicely, that Dashamul means that in Chaitanya Charitamrita is there Dashamul, and in Gita also has Dashamul, Bhagavat also has Dashamul, everyone Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written differently so that we can get a topmost understanding, and Srimad Bhagavatam. So in this Dashamul, that all kind of one is that Shibha Vastu, which is the worshipable Vastu, and all kind of explanation is given about that Shibha Vastu. This all Bhakti Thakur children. So whatever the case, that Dashamul, that it's very much important to discuss that Dashamul. That Dashamul Tattva is very much important to discuss. So in this Sambandh Abhidhi and Prayojan, all kind of knowledge you can get regarding Sambandh Abhidhi and Prayojan. And what Bhagavan already speaking, that Shastra is from that Dashamul, it is getting manifested. And just by understanding that Dashamul, that Naam Rup Gun Leela of Harinam Sankirtan, after getting that from a pure Guru Vaishnav, that Sat Guru, that non-stop automatically when you are practicing, that kind of non-stop practice, you just need to make it into a constant practice so that that you can get that Tattva Chakshu, that Tattva Darshan you can get, and you can get manifested, and that kind of importance is given to that Tattva Chakshu, Tattva Darshan, because we know. And another, we have lot of shlokas. All we know this kind of these shlokas have already listened. This all vichar is there, which we need to understand every day and every fraction of second we need to understand. So this sadhu sang also, it is very much important to understand, about which in Bhagavad-ji Mahapuran that already written. You just remember the point what actually written here. Here what is written there? Here written actually that anarth, when it is going away, it is just going away, your anarth. In this what will happen, that all the time that Nitya Bhagavat Seva, Transcendental Bhagavatam Seva means that Shastra Rupi, that kind of Bhagavatam, Granth Bhagavat and Bhakta Bhagavat, it is actually, and Vaishnava Rupi Bhagavat, that Bhakta Bhagavat, it is actually getting into consideration. We just need to get the consideration of both the Bhagavats, Granth Bhagavat and Bhakta Bhagavat, and by not giving this, we cannot get Bhakti at all. Nothing bhakti cannot come at all. Shuddha bhakti, pure bhakti. That's why that shastra, the shastras are the actual eyes, and sadhu sangha, association of sadhus, the shastras are the eyes to follow that. And what Brahmaji has already speaking in the shloka, Brahmaji already speaking. Sthanasthita means that. Sadhugan Sakhaste Sthitaha means that which is the actual place of all the pure Guru Vaishnava, where pure Guru Vaishnava are residing all the time. It does is means that Vishwanath Chakravarti very nicely speaking. It means that Sadhugan Sakhaste Sthitaha, that with association of sadhus you just need to do. Why? Because that all pure Guru Vaishnava, just by getting their association, that topmost advantage we can get. Why? Because they are apart from absolute truth. They are not at all speaking about anything else apart from absolute truth. Understand the point? That they are not at all actually discussing about material things at all. And there is no other pathway open at all. So this is the actual reason. That's why that Shastra Alochana means that Granth Bhagavat and Bhakta Bhagavat, both of them you just need to worship all the time. Why importance is given to them? Because pure Guru Vaishnava have that Sadachar, topmost Sadachar. By following that, we can practice Naam Sankirtan, and that kind of exemplary thing and kind of ignition we can get, acceleration in our bhajan. And by following all pure Guru Vaishnav, getting acceleration in bhajan, that kind of 10 naam, kind of naam aparad we can get out of that. And just by getting onto that pathway of pure Guru Vaishnav, that kind of practice we just need to do in the form of sadhana bhakti all the time. That is actually called sadhana, under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnav. Abhyas means to do practice under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnav. This all actually written. And after that, Bhagwan, actually Arjun speaking to Bhagwan afterwards, that to just control our mind is very impossible, next to impossible. Just to control our mind, and it is extremely impossible, not at all possible at all. How it is possible? That Bhagwan actually is putting Arjun Puri's question in front of Bhagwan. To just, it is just like wind, your mind. You cannot control it at all. But to satisfy Bhagwan, it is possible just by getting the association of pure Guru Vaishnav. So it is impossible to control your mind, which is just like wind. But just you go on trying. This kind of practice is already written by Bhagwan. It means that kind of sadhana and kind of practice you just need to do all the time. Regularly you just need to do that practice, slowly, steadily. That kind of prem bhakti, it will definitely get manifested inside your heart. That prem bhakti, about that, this, and in rag marg also, this kind of prem bhakti we can get also. So whatever be the case, by that we can understand one point, that this 59th number shloka, a bit of explanation I have given here, right, regarding this. And whatever next 60th number shloka, in this very in-depth vichar is there. What written here actually? Here actually written here. Here it is actually written here that yasya, this bhakti, that over this nothing is there apart from bhakti. That is the topmost thing which you can get. That is the topmost. Bhakti is the topmost. Apart from it, nothing is more topmost than bhakti. Because apart from this, nothing is more topmost. Apart from this, bhakti from bhakti, nothing is topmost, because we know and in Hari Bhakti Vilas also it is written. It's already written there. You can get the actual proof of the Shastras as well. That Bhagwan actually speaking to Uddhav, that that all the devotees, I am actually loving them a lot. So much love I am actually giving to my devotees. It is the topmost thing. Bhagwan actually speaking this point to Uddhav. Apart from it, nothing is more topmost. That is the topmost. Bhakti is the topmost. Apart from that, nothing is more topmost. We need to understand this point very carefully. Apart from bhakti, nothing is more topmost from bhakti. This Bhagwan all the time actually speaking. In Hari Bhakti Vilas also it is written. Why? This all actually written. Lot of things have already been spoken here by Bhagwan Shri Krishna. Everything Bhagwan has speaking, already speaking here. So this all kind of proofs are there. And on the basis of all these proofs, we can see that this is the topmost thing what we can get. That without all, that bhakti is so much rare to get, so much rare gem it is. So here actually it is written, here about nivritti it is spoken, that nivritti and pravritti, both the words actually it is being, we just need to understand what is nivritti and what is pravritti. Nivritti means that just by doing slowly, steadily, we can understand, that is called nivritti, that is nivritt marg. And pravritti means that to some objects we have some desire to do that particular thing. That kind of desire, we know we need to complete that desire. So if whether it is written there, about this, by this, that nivritti you can get. Bhagwan actually speaking to Brahma, that beta, Brahma, Bhagwan actually speaking to Brahma, what he is speaking, that beta, you see, that apart from this, topmost, nothing is more topmost than bhakti, neither in future nor in present, neither in past, that is the topmost, bhakti is the topmost, apart from that, nothing is more topmost, that with this, topmost permanent nivritti one jiva can get. About this, in about Bhagavad Dharma, in the definition of Bhagavad Dharma, it is written there. This is the actual suprasidati, topmost manifestation of pure bhakti, that he can get the topmost transcendental happiness in his life. Bhakti is actually striling, feminine gender. So that's why we just be careful on this point. So this was actually written here, no? That is actually feminine gender, Atma. That's why it is written Yasyaha. Here Srishti Tattva, sixth case ending. Shishti means sixth case ending is used here. That apart from that, that by that you can get Nivritti. That is a very fine object. That by that only one can understand me and one can practice sadhana onto my lotus feet. And Jivatma, that can get the Param Nivritti, can go to the pathway of Param Nivritti, and the Jivatma can go onto that pathway. And those by this vichar, that who are actually doing my sadhana by this process, that by that sadhana bhakti, that same sadhana bhakti and it'll go forward, it will just give rise to that prema bhakti. So that's why Prabhupada always used to speak all the time that O Mahoday Gan, that in the category of bhakti, that categorical vichar of bhakti, you just don't disregard it or don't misunderstand that. O Mahoday Gan, that sadhana bhakti prem bhakti, that whatever kind of division is there, sadhana bhakti, prem bhakti and bhav bhakti, you understand the point what I'm speaking. So this what is there, you just need to understand it, you just need to understand perfectly, only then only you can understand that completely. And only and only prem bhakti, by that only that you can get the lotus feet of Krishna. You can get the lotus feet of Krishna just by getting that prema bhakti, that already it is Bhagwan actually speaking to Brahmaji Maharaj regarding this. Sadhan bhakti, bhav bhakti and prem bhakti. About this, I'll be just speaking it tomorrow. So this Prabhupada actually speaking to us. Now, the actual question is coming. That actual question is coming here, that by that Bhagwan, that kind of five shloki, that in the last Bhagwan speaking that five shloki, that by this sadhana bhakti, that jivas can get the topmost paramanand only by prem bhakti. Only that lotus feet of Krishna you can get. Krishna charan, lotus feet of Krishna, you can get only by lotus feet of Krishna you can get. And those jivas, that kind of sadhya jiva, sadhya bhakti, those people who are just taking this sadhya bhakti with full careful and conscious mood, he is actually doing that, having this target. He is actually taking that kind of sadhan bhakti. It is very much important to discuss that. Definitely, that sadhya devotee, definitely they will get that sadhya vastu. It is not like that if they are not at all following it properly, they are actually following it properly and they are not at all getting it. It's not like that. Definitely they will get that sadhya vastu. So there is no kind of contamination. Why? Because Bhagwan is not at all cheater. So those jivas, that same sadhya bhakti, they are following it properly with full conscious and careful bhav, according to the association of sadhus, that they are actually discussing this sadhya bhakti all the time, that for them that sadhan tattva, that sadhya tattva, to get that, it is not at all impossible for them. Definitely that sadhan object of worship will definitely come in front of him. He will definitely get that sadhya vastu in his life. And some other person who is not at all sincere in sadhan bhakti, he cannot get that at all, that sadhya vastu. For him it is not at all possible, but for others who are actually fixed in their target, it is possible for them to get that sadhya vastu. So it is not at all possible for others who are insincere. Tomorrow I will be just giving very special discussion on this point, in very in-depth vichar I will speak on this, more discussion I will be doing on that. And today up till this point I will just be giving rest. It is very much essential. And the shloka which I have already started with, that you are the actual controller of all the akinchan devotees, and all other persons cannot get you at all. Why? Because if he is getting a very nice opulent bhav, and he is a very big intelligent person materially, but he is actually very nice looking, so this is all actually one kind of obstruction in the way of bhakti. That's why we can get false ego regarding that. And in Hari Bhajan, if false ego is there, then Hari Bhajan is not at all possible. That in material situation, material platform, if you are there, then Hari Bhajan is not at all possible at material platform at all. If false ego is there, then Hari Bhajan is not possible. So up till here, I'll be just giving rest today. That you are all only and only you are dear and near of Nishkinchan devotees, and apart from that, those who are not at all Nishkinchan, you are not at all dear to them.